Welcome back. In focus now is Bangalore, whose population explosion has had an interesting consequence. New ward data from the BBMP has revealed that the city's population in the core areas is on a decline, while population in the peripheral areas is rising. Lakshmi Sivadas finds out which pockets in Bangalore's periphery holds the most promise for the future.
The Roys used to live in a rented house in Bangalore's posh Wilson Garden area for over two decades. However, when it was time for them to buy their own property, they had little choice but to move away.
Wilson Garden, the area has become very congested. And congestion is one thing which I personally like to avoid. Prices which they are quoting in and around that area, like Banargatta Road or Wilson Garden and all these things, are all maybe 10,000 plus, which how many people can really afford?
While the Roys is a case of wanting to move away from a crowded area, they aren't the only ones making the move. Recent data released by Bangalore's corporator, the BBMP, has shown that while Bangalore's population had exploded by 44% in the last decade, the core areas of Bangalore have been seeing a decline in population. Core areas like Shantalanagar, Chikpet, Basavangudi and Richmond Town have seen the population decline by as much as 31%. Meanwhile, the suburban areas saw a rise in population by as much as 200% in some areas. Experts say that with its coming of age as a metro, Bangalore is now following in the footsteps of cities like Mumbai and Delhi.
The trend now is to move closer to the office space or somewhere which is the travel time is about 15-20 minutes. And where the schools, there are schools also present in suburb areas. People would still prefer to be there than stay in CBD. So 80% of our buyers are the end users. So they would prefer a location where things are very close by.
Core area becomes too much congested and being deprived of necessary amenities. The people living in those areas, they start shifting. It has happened in Calcutta with Bada Bazar kind of an area. It has happened in Mumbai with Kalwa Devi kind of a thing. And it is happening in Bangalore now, where people from Chikpet, people from Wilson Garden and other areas who have been living there for ages, right? They would like to go out to live in bigger homes, better homes with more amenities.
Another reason for the decline in population is the increased commercialization of core residential areas.
The infrastructure doesn't follow the development. So if you start planning the suburbs well enough with a high enough density, then it starts warranting that level of infrastructure.
Experts say it's crucial to chart a growth plan for suburbs in order to avoid income inequality across the city. From Bengaluru, Lakshmi Sivadas for NDTV.
Okay, staying with Bangalore, Vishwanath Patil on the line with us. Vishwanath, hi, where do you want to invest?
Yeah, hi, good afternoon. Actually, I was looking for the invest in electronics. I was looking for electronic city.
Okay.
I already shortlisted one, like Patil Realty.
Okay. And your budget is?
Budget is around 50 to 60 lakhs.
Okay. So, Vishwanath has selected Smondo 4 in New Town by Patil Realty. This is a project in Electronic City. He has a budget about 50 to 60 lakhs. Sameer, we have been recommending this property on our shows previously. Would you go ahead with that?
Yeah, you know, this is a very peculiar situation. We've been recommending this project for a long time. We really like the developer. We really like the project. Three phases have already been delivered in this project. However, the fourth phase is having some trouble with respect to getting the licenses. And the project has been on pre-launch for the last 1 year. So that is causing us a bit of concern. And probably that's the only reason why we would say that at this point in time, now that the licenses have not come, either you wait for the licenses to come and then go into the project because there's nothing else wrong with this project, or you avoid it totally and look at some other projects because there's enough options in the same price points to choose from and good projects as well. This micro market is doing fairly well. 16 months of inventory overhang, so very safe. Weighted average price is 4050, and price appreciation has also been decent at about 12% on an annualized basis. The three projects that you can consider are Concord, Tech Turf, this is at 3900, located just off the Electronic City phase 1 near the Wipro complex. The project will be ready by first quarter 2016, and they're offering you all the amenities, and it's a 148 unit apartment size, number of units is 148, which means It's a relatively decent sized, not too many people. Gym, jogging track, children's play area, clubhouse, indoor games are all being offered in this project. The second project is Team Emblem. This project is also a mid-sized project of 116 units at 4,000. Amenities here are also good enough. Swimming pool, meditation garden, senior citizen garden, children's pool. Total area is about 2 acres and will be ready by end of 2017. Lastly, we have Shanders, Dwellington by Shanders at 3850. This is the largest project of 406 units. Of 6 blocks plus 7 floors of 3.5 acres of land. So density is average, I would say, and amenities like children play area, badminton court, basketball rings, jogging track and swimming pool are there in this project as well.
Okay, Vishwanath, Smondoville 4 by Patel Realty, a good project but unfortunately struck by delays because the developer has been unable to procure licenses for this project. So we would advise that you look at projects which would be ready in a few years' time. We're giving you two picks to be ready in 2 years, Concord Tech Turf by Concord Group and the other being Esteem Emblem by Esteem Group. And we have another one, Shanders Dwellington by Shanders. With that, we close the show for today. Your questions are welcome for property markets and projects across India. Write to us at property@ndtv.com or connect with us on our phone lines or on Radio City every Saturday between 2 to 3 p.m. Thank you for staying with me and Sameer. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.